In today's video, I want to talk about something more relevant, something from today, quantum computers. You hear about quantum computers in the news, people are talking about them, and you're probably wondering whether the hype is actually worth paying attention to. Don't worry, I'll break it down in a simple way so that by the end of this video, you will know exactly what matters. First, let's focus on the second half of the word, computing. I assume you already know how regular computers work, but here's a quick recap. Everything in a regular computer boils down to bits, tiny switches that can be either on or off. In other words, one or zero. That's how your phone, laptop, or even your smart toaster process information. Quantum computers takes things to a whole new level. Instead of bits, they use something called qubits. Now we know that a bit can only be either one or zero, but a qubit, thanks to something called superposition, can be one, zero, or both at the same time. Confused? Well, don't worry, I'll explain it without bringing up Schrödinger's cat. Imagine you have two switches instead of one, and each switch can be either on, which is one, or off, which is zero, just like bits. But now, also imagine that these two switches are connected in a special way, so that when one of them is on, the other one is always off, and vice versa. Now suppose you have a device that lets you check the state of one of the switches. The moment you measure one, you immediately know the state of the other, right? No delay, no waiting, because remember, they are connected. Everything I explained so far is basically called quantum entanglement, and it's one of the wildest things about quantum mechanics. These quantum linked particles behave as if they share information instantly, no matter how far apart they are, whether on the other side of the world or at the farthest edge of the galaxy. Okay, we have covered quantum entanglement and how switches are connected to each other. But I know now you're wondering, you said that they can be one, zero, or both at the same time. And both at the same time? Why is that? Well, it's because we don't actually know if a switch is on or off until we measure it. And when we do measure it, we don't just reveal its state. It actually picks a state at that moment. Imagine every time we measure it, it's like rolling a dice. It's not that the switch was secretly on or off, but rather the act of measuring forces it to choose a state. So until we measure, it exists in a mix of both states. And each time we measure it, we force it to pick a state. But the outcome is completely random based on the probability. Now, let's get back to our regular computers before we go crazy with physics. In our regular computers, none of the switches are connected to each other this way. They all work independently. But as we have covered so far, in quantum computers, they are connected. And because of superposition and entanglement, quantum computers can process information in a way that our regular computers simply cannot. While a classic computer solves problems step by step, a quantum computer can explore multiple solutions at the same time, making it exponentially faster for certain types of calculations. For example, in tasks like factoring large numbers, which is the basis of modern encryption, a quantum computer can explore many possible factors simultaneously, drastically reducing the computation time. Basically, wherever we have many possibilities to check, since quantum computers can look at multiple possibilities at the same time, they are way faster than our regular computers. Sounds amazing, right? But don't start throwing your laptop into the trash just yet. Because quantum computers are a mess. They're fragile, they're error-prone. Let's dive into why. First things first, quantum computers are incredibly sensitive. The tiniest disturbance like heat, radiation, or someone sneezing in the next room can mess up their calculations. Because of this, they make mistakes, a lot of mistakes. Writing reliable quantum algorithms is like trying to write with a pen that randomly licks ink all over the page. Also, most quantum computers today only have a few dozen qubits. For quantum computing to change the world, we will need thousands, maybe millions. So yeah, they're not exactly replacing your laptop tomorrow. Okay, so far we have covered the physics behind it, why they're faster, and why they won't be instantly changing the world. But don't get me wrong, we will most likely end up using them heavily in the future. And it's not just about physics. There are many new opportunities for us, computer nerds. Quantum computers don't run your regular apps. They need special algorithms that can take advantage of all that quantum weirdness. And guess what? We don't have many of those yet. And since quantum computers make mistakes, we need brilliant minds to figure out how to fix them. Think of it like building a grammar check, but for quantum math. Also, quantum computers aren't replacing classical computers right away. They'll have to work with them. So we need systems that let the two talk to each other seamlessly. Finally, I want to highlight one more important thing. Quantum computers are revolutionary, but we often don't appreciate just how fast and advanced our regular computers already are. In fact, there are many tasks where classical computers are still just as fast or even faster than quantum computers. To name a few, basic arithmetic, everyday computation, web browsing, gaming, video encoding, and finally, streaming. In these areas, our computers are already fast enough, and switching to quantum computing wouldn't make a noticeable difference for us. In conclusion, quantum computers will definitely replace normal computers, but not now or not anytime in the near future. Quantum computers may be available for practical use in the 2030s, but it's difficult to predict an exact date. So far, the development of quantum computers has been really slow. So once again, please do not throw away your computers. Thank you guys for watching. I know that you forgot to like and subscribe, but I'll see you in another video.